rematch. It's high noon for John Wayne Hibbert, who's out for revenge against Commonwealth champion Dave Ryan. Remember, you're watching a special event on Sky Sports Box Office, where the pictures will encrypt at 6 o'clock for Sky customers to continue watching. Press this box office button on your Sky remote, select sport, and follow the instructions. So Biz Night in store. We open with our commentators. This evening, it's the Smiths. Yes, not the group. They're our boys. Hello, boys. Let's get to the entry first.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC International and Commonwealth Light Welterweight titles. Let's welcome the fighters to the ring. Join us first in the red corner, Dave Ryan.
It's a late afternoon kickoff around the same time zone as James DeGale was presented with. Out in Boston, no harm at all as the golden boy from Beijing struck gold on the eastern seaboard. How will this time affect the early birds here? Because it's title fights all the way. And this man has not enjoyed much fanfare, picking up paydays, but increasingly important wins. He is the Commonwealth champion at 10 stone, and at 32, well, it just might be the time for him now, Paul.
It might be, and he's been impressing recently. He's having good performances, and he's just got to keep on winning and keep on progressing. The Commonwealth title's a great start, and see what he can do from there.
Dave Ryan, and unusually, the champion comes in first.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the blue corner, John Wayne Hibbert. Touching me,
touching you. The challenger gets the major entrance, and I wonder if that's because he has sold hundreds of tickets here. The popular improver, John Wayne Hibbert. He's from the ancient Essex village of Horndon on the Hill, and he has a string of recent knockouts and a growing fan base, which has taken him into this chance tonight. And also, Paul, it doubles up as an opportunity to exact revenge on Ryan, who beat him last time they fought.
It does, and that's always an added incentive. Obviously, you know, we don't even need to say that. But it was a good fight last time. We need to see better tonight. We need to see more action, and it's a massive chance, as you say, to reverse that decision.
He's been a couple of years younger. They're the same height and virtually the same weight, tucked inside the 10 stone limit. And look at that reach as well. There is very little to choose on the statistics. Hibbert maybe packs a bigger punch, but Dave Ryan did have Tyrone Nurse in all sorts of trouble to win this belt, so may hit harder than that suggests. And have a look at this, 8-13 on, 5-4 against. You really cannot split them. The draw might be worth a go at 22-1. It should be close, this.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is brought to you by Eddie Hearn for Matchroom Sport in association with Sky Sports Box Office and sponsored by Daffabab, Lonsdale, and StubHub. Sanctioned by the WBC, the supervisor is Mauro Betti from Italy. The Commonwealth representative will be Stephen Hiscock. The three judges scoring this fight at ringside will be Jeff Hines from Reading, Steve Gray from Fleetwood, and Dave Parris from Leeds. And when the bell rings, our third man in the ring in charge of the actions is the referee, hailing from Paisley, Scotland. Please welcome Victor Loughlin. Introducing to first, the fighter on my left, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black and pink, his official weight, 9 stone, 13 pounds, 3 ounces. His record stands at 16 wins and 8 defeats, including 3 KO victories. He comes to us from Derby. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the reigning and defending Commonwealth Light Welterweight Champion, Dave Rocky Ryan.
The Rocky! The And introducing his opponent on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing gray, blue, and yellow. Yesterday, he tipped the scales at 9 stone, 13 pounds. He enters the ring with 15 wins, 9 of those by KO and 2 defeats. He comes to us from Harden on the Hill. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the reigning and defending WBC International Light Welterweight Champion, John Wayne Hibbert.
Okay, gents, you've had your instructions in the dressing room. Remember, obey my commands at all time, defend yourselves at all time. God bless. Touch gloves. Let's do it.
One of the best in the business now, Victor Lachlan, the referee here. And Paul was just telling me that maybe the reason that Dave Ryan came in first is because this man, John Wayne Hibbert, is the WBC international champion at 10 stone. In my book, that's not as big
second
as the Commonwealth title,
round.
But...
Mine neither, you're right, but at the end of the day, that's what the fighters must think.
First pick'em, title clash on the card, everyone has been talking about. Exciting fighters in tight matches on this deep, deep bill. And this is a rematch. Dave Rocky Ryan, who pipped John Wayne Hibbert a couple of years ago in a small hall show in Grays, now in this cavernous arena, who will take the spoils. Ryan had a great start against Tyrone Nurse, knocking him down a couple of times early on, but had a really battle to win that Commonwealth title. And what of John Wayne Hibbert, who's just starting to get going, get some momentum in his career, and there's a nice combination early.
It was a good right hand that got through. I said at the start of the round, I was thinking it was a pretty slow pace and they were feeling each other out, but a minute in, they're straight to action, straight away, letting the shots go.
There's the jab from Ryan. A little reddening around the eye of Hibbert, even this early in the first round, but no feeling out process. And here comes Hibbert, buoyed by that good run of form and beginning to find the punches early. Timing spot on so far.
You're right about the redness around Hibbert's left eye. Doesn't seem to affect him too much this early on, but you're right, straight away. Feeling all process lasts about 30 seconds and a straight in.
Tries to get his jab going. Ryan, who under the tutelage of Clifton Mitchell has not really turned his career around. It's been a tough slog. Hibbert trying to make a very fast start. And Ryan missing badly. Difficult period as well, though, for Ryan since the Tyrone Nurse fight. Meant to be fighting Bradley Saunders. Saunders pulled out of that, and so he's just been waiting around. And Hibbert is fighting and appearing more regularly, especially on these type of nights. And he's getting his punches off first here in the first round. Good right as well.
Nice right hand over the top from Hibbert. Good work rate and good volume of punches from Hibbert, which is what's been the better of this round so far. He's throwing threes and fours more regularly than Ryan. Ryan's throwing pretty much singles and one-twos.
Trying to find the body, just misses. Ryan comes back with a couple of his own. Hibbert just disorganized for a moment. Does hit quite hard, Ryan. Looking for the uppercut, partially blocked. How about this for a first round of a night that we haven't seen the like of in a long, long time in Britain? Welcome back to the O2 here in the capital. Carl Greaves, who's got behind this man, John Wayne Hibbert, and it was a positive start from him.
To be fair, it was a good start from both, but with Hibbert, a lot more combination punching, twos, threes and fours, and then going again with a second phase, whereas Ryan was pretty limited to counters and the odd 1-2 here and there. But the stronger fighter looks to be Ryan, but the busier fighter is Hibbert, and that's what took him the first round.
Rocky on the waistband for Dave Ryan from Derby, the 32-year-old in fight number 25. And he's in with John Wayne Hibbert in the grey, blue and yellow. And I think I noticed an Arsenal emblem on the trunks. Arsenal, of course, in the FA Cup final against Villa. Will it be a double for John Wayne Hibbert tonight? Ryan just trying to get that jab going again. He has the experience of going 12 with Tyrone Nurse. Really good win that, wasn't it, Paul?
It was. It was. We were there. It was a good win. And he really done well on the night. Nurse was brave and game, but Ryan was just far too strong.
Just backing off Hibbert. Just selecting to box a bit more. Surprising after the success he had with the combinations. Maybe he's felt Ryan's power early. Only three knockouts on the slate. But I was talking to Gavin Deakin, who works on our punch statistics alongside, who shared a ring with Dave Ryan and said he hits much harder than that.
I said that around before, he looks the stronger fighter. And you know, you always notice with a puncher as well, who knows they can punch in a heavier-handed fighter, they'll always be more patient and take the time a bit more. You know, they can get you anywhere, they can catch you with that shot, but you know, he's not the biggest banger in the world, but he is heavy-handed, and you could be exactly right, thinking that Hibbert's felt the power sit early on.
More reddening around that left eye of John Wayne Hibbert, as Ryan just flicks with a jab and tries the uppercut, but certainly, where are the combinations that he was throwing Hibbert in the first? Just waiting, isn't he?
He is. And you think that the precedent was set after the first round. That's how it's going to go for you. Go out and carry on with them combinations. You've got your foot in the door now. You've warmed up nicely. Carry on where you left off. But he hasn't. He's come out and there's no combinations this round. And he's letting Ryan dictate.
Yeah, much better round this for Dave Ryan, standing tall, delivering his shots, and just tentative here from Hibbert, and he just sort of falls in there, no real control. It's an odd session this, the second, from John Wayne Hibbert. Can't explain it, Paul.
You made a great point early on in the round that he may have just felt Ryan's power.
Yep, one each. Well, we thought this would be close, and John Wayne Hibbert, we felt, took the opener, but Dave Ryan came back at him, Paul.
He did. Nice jab, judging the distance well. But what we noticed in that round from Ryan is dictating from the centre of the ring. He took the centre of the ring, even backing Hibbert up a lot of the time. And he took the round for me, definitely.
Third round, this is the 165th of Dave Ryan's career, which started back in 2007. Hibbert turned in 2009. This is his 91st round. So the seasoning, the experience is with the champion, Dave Ryan from Derby, who's come down to Hibbert's backyard once more. Well, it's hardly his backyard, but it certainly is his area. And the fans that are in early doors at the O2 are Hibbert's. Bundles of them. Popular guy, the man from Essex. Bit of a throwback, isn't he, John Wayne Hibbert?
He is, and 700 odd tickets sold tonight, apparently, as well. It's a good right hand from him, though. Ryan wants to just be a bit careful coming in. It's okay, thinking you can dictate, but good left to counter to retain. You need to stay switched on, be mindful of what's coming back.
Good defence there from Ryan, both having their successes, and that right hand starting to work for John Wayne Hibbert. This is more positive from him. But Ryan answers, already beginning to brew into a good, tough battle this between Hibbert and Ryan for the Commonwealth crown, and plenty of pride as well. Remember, Ryan has the win over Hibbert before. Hibbert felt he should have got the nod. Controversial. Will they settle it tonight? Down he goes. Dave Ryan and Hibbert. Well, he'd found the punches in this third round, and Ryan in trouble. He gets up, But he looks bewildered, Paul.
We said early on in the round, you need to be mindful of what's coming back, especially when you're attacking. You can't just go in with your hands down expecting to hurt someone or walk through someone.
These punches hurting Dave Ryan. Bravely tries to fight fire with fire, but he's trapped on those ropes. And Hibbert has got plenty of time left in the round. These rights getting through. Ryan has to suck it up. But much, much better this from Hibbert. But there's a cut as well by his right eye. It is all happening here. And it's so early in the night.
It is. It started off nicely. I said before in the round, he needs to be careful about walking in. But Ryan seems to have recovered and is now backing Hibbert up.
And that cut, that won't help Hibbert's plans. Or maybe he'll just go for broke here. The right hand working a treat. Good combinations. Can he deck Dave Ryan again? Or will Ryan see out these last 15 seconds of what's been a terrific third?
Ryan's legs look okay again now. He thinks he seems to have weathered the storm. He seems to be back strong on his feet again, but
what a round. And Hibbert raises his eyebrows. He had the success, he got the knockdown, but he's picked up the cup.
That was beautiful there. Taking a box now. Heavy box. Yeah.
Look at that. Close your eye.
How bad is it?
That's fucking lovely.
It looks to be on the lid from here. It's that counter right hand again. You know, Ryan's walked it. The clash of heads after it won't have helped. But you can't walk in just bludgeoning forwards because you've got the strength on someone. You're going to walk onto counters. That was a nice overhand right hand from Hibbert. Good shot. You can tell Ryan's hit and he's got a bit of sense about him as well. As he stands up, then he takes the knee again.
It's been a strange performance so far, this, from John Wayne Hibbert, hasn't it? All combinations in the first, went to sleep in the second, yeah. And right hand happy in the third, which did the job.
Yeah, took a round off, basically, and I don't know why. I think what you said was right. He probably felt Ryan's power, but he's certainly well back in this fight now.
Maybe they both felt it in there. What next in this Commonwealth light welterweight title fight? Good belt held by many decent fighters, especially over the last 10-15 years, one of which Eamon McGee, and we do send our huge sympathy out to the former Southpaw great fighter after the tragic loss of his son in the last 24 hours or so. Yeah. Tragic that, wasn't it?
It was, and sincere condolences to the family.
Eamon, very, very popular in the boxing fraternity. Did it his own way, of course, in a ring. And John Wayne Hibbert and Dave Ryan doing it their way and trying to follow their paths to title glory. He's got the Commonwealth belt, Ryan, and Hibbert with this WBC international, but they want more hungry fighters. And at the moment, they're putting on a good scrap for us.
I think the right eye looks to be affecting Hibbert just a little bit. It seems to be either a piece of Vaseline, a piece of skin or something, just what I can see out of the view I'm in. But we need to get a good close-up on that and have a look. But he's dabbing away at it.
Looking for the right hand again, Hibbert. Just a bit scrappier this fourth. Can't get his jab going, though, Ryan. Not really finding his range. And when he ups the volume, the pace, Hibbert, that's where he has his success. It's the Ryan jab, isn't it? Against the volume and right hand of Hibbert at the moment.
It is, and if Ryan's sensible, the knockdown could have been the best thing that happened to him, because he was just plodding forward and trying to overpower Hibbert before, whereas now he's boxing a bit smarter now and he's using his jab a bit better.
Cuffing right hand from Ryan this time. Blood from the nose, and there's a right from Ryan. That's better punch picking from the Midlander. Both men have been up for this all week. Huge respect between them, though, as well, because they've shared the ring before. Just driving the punches back. This has been better from Ryan, especially after he found himself on the canvas in the previous round.
He's controlling things a little bit better this round. You know, he's not even keeping the centre. He's on the back foot, but he's boxing smarter. He's using the jab better, and he's keeping a better defence. And as I said, the knockdown may have been a good thing for him, as daft as that sounds.
The Super O2 Arena. We've had Frotch Kessler here, DeGale Groves. Not to forget another one of those down the years. We've got, at the moment, a terrific battle brewing for the Commonwealth Light Welterweight title. Dave Ryan and John Wayne Hibbert. You couldn't pick a winner at this stage, could you, Paul?
No, you can't. It's close. The knockdown's probably the deciding factor at the minute, but the cut's also playing a factor. You know, it's affecting him. It's affecting Hibbert. He's dabbing away at it, and Ryan seems to be getting back in the driving seat again.
Hibbert scoring the knockdown in the third round, but marked up and cut. And a better fourth from Dave Ryan. Again, looking for that wide right hand. Just crept quietly towards this Commonwealth title, Ryan. It was excellent in Leeds against Tyrone Nurse. Also beat Paul McCloskey. Lost to Sam Eggington. He complained about that. Some of these fights very, very close. And here's another. Forward, forward, saying Clifton Mitchell from the red corner alongside us. Hibbert trying to get his own work out, but Ryan just growing in confidence here, trying to push Hibbert backwards, Paul.
He isn't. He just needs to be a bit careful. That's what got him knocked down last time, going forward without any defence and being careful of what's coming back. But he seems a stronger fighter again now, and he's landing a bit more. Good combinations coming back from Hibbert, though. But
most on the gloves, though.
Most on the gloves and elbows, exactly.
It's good defences at times from Ryan. Clifton Mitchell was so proud of his man after he did Tyrone Nurse. And look at this from Ryan. It's a real drive, and Hibbert has to hold on. Can he respond? He tries, but again, the gloves so tight. Whipping the body shots in now, Hibbert. Really good action. And down he goes. He did find one. And Ryan's down for the second time.
The main right hand that done the damage, Adam, was two right hands to the body ago. It was the very first right hand to the body, landed right under the elbow.
Just looks in his corner, hurt there, wincing in pain. The defence wasn't tight enough, and there's another body shot from Hibbert. So he's hurt him downstairs, and he's hurt him to the head. And Hibbert now driving himself forward. Can he break Ryan? This is brave from the Derby man. He's hauled himself up a couple of times. What next?
Hibbert needs to just make himself a little bit of room. Don't smother his work in close.
Something looked tired there,
yeah,
Hibbert.
Big gulp of air as he stands back. It's about being clever now, picking the shot and finding that body shot.
Blood to the nose of Hibbert too. Might affect breathing if this goes on through the latter rounds, but will it? Ryan suddenly with a new lease of life. What a good fight.
Great
to
fight.
Kick off this night.
Big right hand from Ryan there. It's just hurt Hibbert as well. Ebb and flow.
Uppercut two, and Ryan finishes the stronger man despite being on the floor. What a cracker.
It's striking you in, Sam. There was a lovely rain there, but it's striking you in. What he wants to know. You're winning it.
10-8 round because of the knockdown. I guess you have to score it, but Ryan came right back at him.
He did come back. He did that, and for me, he come on back. He finished strong also, and he hurt Hibbert towards the end. And you said yourself, we saw Hibbert take a big gulp of air. It's heartbreaking and demoralising sometimes when you're giving someone your best shot, and that was the main shot that done the damage for me. And the second one that goes in after it is the one that just pushes him over there.
That's a good spot, Paul. He was hurt by that, and it was a delayed reaction.
The very first shot, and you know when you're inside and you got your head on someone's head, you hear the noise they make when that body shot lands, and you can tell by the way he went in so fast for the second right hand and the third right hand that he hit him.
Just looks a little tired in that corner, Hibbert, and springs on his toes, but Dave Ryan's very fast out of the traps. I wonder if they believe that despite the two knockdowns he's suffered, he can break Hibbert up with just his resilience and his strength and his extra experience here.
I wouldn't be surprised if he did that. I mean, he's a strong fighter, and Hibbert is, you know, he is looking tired. He's starting to feel the pace a little bit. And as I said before, it's a bit demoralizing when you've had someone down twice and he just keep coming and just keep coming.
He's got these very broad shoulders, hasn't he? Fitness fanatic as well, Dave Ryan, and they've cultured this style, which has been pretty effective. I mean, few thought he'd get the better of Tyrone Nurse, but he pickpocketed Nurse, and he showed a lot of strength down the stretch. I think he broke his nose in that fight as well. He's a tough guy, and Clifton Mitchell's a very, very good man to have in your corner. Utilizing that jab and the reach as well. Just controlling the ring more now, Ryan. So many shifts in the plot, and we haven't even got to halfway, Paul.
There is. It's been pretty difficult to score, and you know, one round one way, one round the other way, but Ryan is relentlessly strong.
Just dabs at his nose again, Hibbert. He's got a big heart on him, but just has to back off there. It's a little bit disorganized and haphazard, although he does find a body shot again, Hibbert. It's as though he knows he can hurt Ryan, but has he got the ability to keep him down? Good shot from Dave Ryan, that one. He's looking a little bit lost, Hibbert, now.
He's hurt, Hibbert. That right hand got home and it hurt him, it shook him up.
Big drive from Ryan, good body shots. I thought this was going to be a bit of a chess match over 10 rounds. You never know, do you?
No, we don't. 30 seconds the breaking in part lasted, and then they were at each other straight away. It was back to the old routine, and you know, very little feeling out process. And Ryan is now the stronger fighter, walking forwards, and you wouldn't think he'd been down twice.
Paul, is it because they're so excited about appearing on this big card, and they all want to steal the show? So many good fights.
It's a huge show, and every fighter wants to be part of these shows. You want to fight in the O2 Arena.
Good uppercut on the inside from Ryan, and another one. Good round this for the Commonwealth champion. Hibbert brave, but hitting arms and gloves. Not really detonating the shots like he has been.
Hibbert needs the bell.
Can this pace go on? I'm not sure. So often a family affair in boxing. We talk about boxing brothers. Here's Dave Ryan's sister, Sandy, the 21-year-old. She won silver at light welter, this very weight, in this year's World Amateur Championships. Huge congratulations to Sandy and her brother. Is he going to follow suit with a win here, Paul? Question mark.
There is a question mark. That was a big right hand from Dave Ryan under those, what we saw there. And I believe he hurt Hibbert. Hibbert needs to have had a good recovery in that minute there.
What was interesting is I heard Clifton Mitchell say in the corner, you've got to stop him. So because of the two knockdowns, they probably think that he is behind on the cards, although, as Paul says, one or two of these difficult to score as we enter the second half. But will Dave Parris, Steve Gray and Jeff Hines, the three judges, be needed? Some damage as well by the left eye of Hibbert, really marked up tonight. He's had his success, but you just get the feeling that Dave Ryan hasn't gone away, and he could just continue to come on strong and keep hold of his belt. Wonder what the odds are now. Pretty close before the first belt.
You'd have to shade towards Hibbert because of the knockdowns, but Ryan is coming on stronger, and Hibbert's looking tired. Hibbert really needs a second wind, or he needs to take a round off on the back foot boxing and try not to take too much trouble.
Lost five by knockout, Hibbert. Went to the eighth round a couple of times as he tries to come on strong, and his nose looks very bruised. I wonder if it's broken. There is blood coming from it. It's a mess, his face now, John Wayne Hibbert. I mean, if you were just turning on and looking at it as Dave Ryan's gum shield comes out, you wouldn't have thought that Ryan had been on the floor a couple of times by looking at the state of them.
You'd think it was the other way, obviously. You'd look at this fight and you'd swear it was Hibbert that's been down twice and you got the names mixed up, but Ryan is, I know I've said it time and again, Ryan's coming on strong and he's looking the stronger fight at the minute. Hibbert's looking tired, he's losing his shape a little bit, but then he lands some shots like that and looks good.
Has got that power, Hibbert. Has he got the stamina and experience? Has been 10 rounds with Tommy Coward and Leon Finlay and, of course, Dave Ryan, but not the 12. And Ryan has been with Tyrone Nurse. Will that come into play? So I was mentioning the pace and whether they've kept enough for the championship rounds. Better from Ryan again as he pushes Hibbert back, and he's hurt in there. Couple of right hands, and now Hibbert just looking disorganized, but comes back with a right of his own. These domestic dust-ups, Paul Smith, you sometimes just cannot beat them.
These are what you want. You look and you think a fight's going one way, and then a right-hand counter again comes back from Hibbert. It's exactly what you want to watch.
And don't you just love fights when you are not sure, really, at any stage, who is going to win? Good work from Ryan, but look at this volume from John Wayne Hibbert. How much do these two want to take home the Commonwealth belt? Great fight.
Come on, come on, come on, man. Fuck's sake.
Apologise for the swearing. Former European champion Clifton Mitchell, living and breathing every moment with Dave Ryan. Tight-knit team from Derby. And some good stuff from Ryan there.
It was. This is the good work from him on the ropes. Landing big shots. Two or three big shots go through. And then we see Hibbert come back and counter with the right hand, which buzzed up Ryan again. There's the right-hand counter. You know, and it just sort of turns everything back around into Hibbert's favour. But big round for Ryan, I believe. And I believe that's two on the bounce now that he's taken. And the strength is starting to show. Hibbert really needs a second win to kick in as soon as possible.
Here's the eighth round of what's been a real good fight for the Commonwealth 10-stone crown. Champion Dave Ryan, remember, in the black trunks with Rocky around the waistband and the Rams derby. And it's the Arsenal fan, John Wayne Hibbert, at 30 with all the fans in here tonight. He scored a couple of knockdowns and looked on the verge. Ryan looking at his corner, wincing in pain, but he's come back up. What a battler. And he has had his moments. Could be fairly close on the cards. You just don't know. So subjective, of course. Good right hand again from Ryan. Hibbert with the two knockdowns, but Ryan may be pinching some of these rounds.
It's good work from him. And what you were saying in the last round about pacing themselves and the pace of the fight, these two certainly don't look like they've got problems with the fitness because of all pace and because of the pace they're going at. You know, they both got five rounds to go, and they're not pacing themselves or conserving any energy for those rounds. They're letting it all out.
Couple of rights from Hibbert, back comes Ryan, and there's a mark underneath his left eye now, just to add to the drama if we haven't got enough going on. Victor Loughlin breaks them. He's hardly had to do anything. Leave them to fight. And the fans who've got in here early to the 0-2 must be absolutely loving it.
It's a better round from Hibbert. And it might be no coincidence that he hasn't gone searching for it as much as he has in the previous rounds. Going in, pushing in too much. Looking for it a bit too eager. He's taking his time a bit. He's letting his hands go a bit more. But he's not pushing in with his feet too much either.
Walks into an uppercut, though, partially landing from Ryan, really swinging these big shots in. And that left eye looks bad again from Hibbert. Trying to find the body, but those big, strong arms of Ryan just helping him out there. Can he keep the defense together? I think with Ryan, it's all about organization. And if he can do it, he can get home. With Hibbert, It's a little cameo for the right hand from Ryan there. And Hibbert sucks it up. Swings and roundabouts in this one. The bloody mask of John Wayne Hibbert. And the slightly fresher looking Dave Ryan, but still has to watch that big right hand of Hibbert. And the nose again, blood sprays from it from Hibbert. It's really troubling now. And with that breathing, Paul, could be a problem.
Yeah, you're right. Some fighters can't breathe through the mouth. They have to breathe through the nose. If you get a nosebleed, you basically need to open your mouth and breathe a way that you're not used to doing.
I tell you, two people who will be enjoying this, Glenn McCrory and Ed Robinson.
Well, a thrilling battle. Who's handling the pace better, Glenn?
That's very hard to say, isn't it? Because the fight is going one way, then the other. Obviously, Hibbert's had the two knockdowns, but at times he looks as if he's been hurt as well. Ryan looks still very physically strong. You know, he's bringing the fight in there, and it's going really well. What a way to start the evening off.
Dave Ryan showing a lot of heart in there.
Yeah, he certainly is. I mean, he's got great physical strength. He's trying to push the fight forward, he's getting in the center of the ring and he's having some good moments, but then all of a sudden Hibbert comes back and he's getting through some good shots as well. So terrific fight.
Thank you, Glenn.
It is a terrific fight. I know Glenn loves these 50-50 ones, and so do you, Paul. Pick your winner, come on.
If Hibbert keeps his foot on the gas and he can manage to get this second win I keep talking about and keep this work rate up, then I'd have to shade with Hibbert, but the stronger fighter is Ryan, and he just doesn't seem like he's feeling the pace at all.
You've got Hibbert in front, I think.
Just
by a couple. I've got it closer. Those are the knockdowns, 3 and 5.
Yep.
I think there's everything in this.
You couldn't argue either way. It's a close fight. It's just, I'm scoring it round by round as I see it, and I just felt Hibbert just done enough in that round with his combination punching.
Better from Hibbert, and then one shot back from Ryan just jolts Hibbert's chin back. But he's thinking about it more, Hibbert. He is having to take some punishment. But he's just trying to come in and out of range, and Ryan again just clumps one over, and a left and a right, and suddenly Ryan looks the one in the ascendancy, and Hibbert in a spot of bother here. He's about to come apart unless he throws something back. Victor Lachlan's going to have to take a real look, and down he goes! For the first time, Hibbert is on the floor. And it's probably worse than either of the two times Ryan's been down, because his legs seem to have gone. And Victor Lachlan just about lets him back. But there's so much time left in the round. And Dave Ryan on the verge of retaining his Commonwealth crown is going to be stopped. Surely down again.
He's up again
for
too
the
quick,
second
Adam.
Time.
Should have tucked the knee in the first one. And he's up again too quick now.
Bounced up. And he's got a minute and 20 seconds to finish the job here, Ryan. He just bundles him down. No knockdown there. But he is running on empty here. It's instinct from John Wayne Hibbert. He was on the very verge of being halted. And Ryan just needs a couple of clean shots. And it's finally job done. And Victor Lachlan again having a close look. And now it is all over for poor John Wayne Hibbert. What a win for Dave Ryan. Down twice. And still the Commonwealth champion away from home again. A terrific scrap. Your heart goes out to John Wayne Hibbert, who gave it everything. But hats off to Clifton Mitchell and Team Ryan.
Great turnaround. That's exactly what you want. You're off the floor twice to come in and turn a fight around like that. Ryan was looking the stronger fighter. Hibbert was looking like he was tiring. But you still have to do the job. You still have to land those shots to do the damage, to stop the fight. And hats off to Dave Ryan.
Well, well, well. We need to get our breath back because we've got a lot more action ahead of us. But the others, if they follow suit, we're going to be in for a night to remember for a long, long time. Well done, the pair of them. Dave Ryan getting up off the floor and coming back. And it was just that extra strength, experience, defense, and organization. And John Wayne Hibbert, who just fought a strange fight in bursts, hadn't he?
In bursts, the round before, I thought he had a good round. He'd come out and As I said, he wasn't too eager jumping in with his feet, but he was letting his hands go, fast combinations, but staying at a distance where he was safe. The minute he got inside, Ryan was far too strong and was landing those shots with some of the damage in the end. Great sportsmanship from the both, though, as we can see now. You know, they're both walking around the ring, applauding each other. And that's what you want to see in a fight after a fight like that.
Terrific action. It had everything. Cuts, knockdowns, determination, valiance, bravery. And I'll tell you what, Paul, I'd like to see it for a third time.
Yeah, so would I. You see, this is the stoppage, and there's not too much clean landing, but Hibbert's tired, his defence wasn't working, and he was taking too many shots around the side and the back of the head as well, and no arguments with the stoppage.
Just hearing at ringside that Hibbert was up by a couple of points on two cards, just like yours, and level on the other. So poor John Wayne Hibbert, but congratulations to Dave Rocky Ryan, who at 32, well, he's having quite a year, isn't he?
Ladies and gentlemen, we have time of 2 minutes into the round number nine when our referee in charge, Victor Loughlin, steps in and calls a halt to the contest. Your winner by TKO and still the Commonwealth champion and the new WBC International champion, Dave Rocky Ryan.
Well done. Let's also hear it from and John. Great to see the pair embrace. One of the domestic fights of the year, no doubt, when we look back at Christmas, I'm sure. Remember, you're watching a special event on Sky Sports Box Office. The pictures will encrypt at 6 o'clock, so not long now. For Sky customers to continue watching, press the box office button on your Sky remote, select sports, and follow the instructions. You don't want to miss it. What an appetizer.
Great, great start, so hopefully a great night. And he's got a new belt now, Dave Ryan, and there's no stopping him this year, is there? As you said before, he's having a great year, he's having a great time, 32 years of age and getting better with age.
It's a good story, isn't it? You know, somebody that no one really talks about, and he's gone to Leeds, he's beaten Tyrone Nurse, now he's come to John Wayne Hibbert's backyard and he has stopped the popular man. He's sitting alongside Clifton Mitchell, and I bet they can't wait to talk about their experiences in that.
Dave, congratulations. Incredible stuff. Coming back from two knockdowns and looking out of there. What kept you in the fight?
I've got a big heart. Put it that way.
That's an understatement.
Yeah, nice one. Yeah, it was a very, very tough fight. I mean, caught me with a cracking body shot. I've had some trouble with my ribs for the past couple of weeks at the minute. And it got me right on where it was painful. But I sucked it up and come back.
That was the second knockdown, the body shot.
Was it? I can't remember. Well, both knockdowns were good. He hurt me in there. He hurt me more or less every round. He was a very strong kid and fit as well.
You kept coming back at him in a Fight of the Year contender. Could you feel him weakening?
I feel I was getting through to him and hurting him with shots. So I was capitalising on the shots that I was throwing, and it paid off.
It's incredible, though, looking at your record, just three stoppages beforehand. People didn't have you down as a puncher, and you've got those eight losses as well that you've come back from so well.
Yeah, I mean, I'm taking boxing a lot more serious now the past couple of years, and I've created a lot more power, and I'm just onwards and upwards. I'm going to keep winning.
Your sister behind you has done so well as an amateur this year. It's been an incredible year, really, for the whole family.
Yeah, she's an inspiration. She keeps me working hard in the gym as well, so it's good to have her around.
Where do you go from here?
Pardon?
Where do you go from here now?
Go from here, I just want to see what's out there, maybe British title, ask Eddie. European.
Ask Eddie.
Yeah, let's ask Eddie, see what's happening.
Ask Eddie.
Well, with promoter Eddie Hearn, what is next for Dave Ryan?
Well, listen, firstly, massive respect to both guys. You know, this is a tough, tough sport. They both deserve so much credit. They fought a war in there, the first fight of the night at 5 o'clock. You know, we originally had Dave Ryan scheduled to fight Bradley Saunders, of course, and Bradley hurt his hand. He ended up fighting John. We'd love to make that fight in September, October, but John will be back 100%. You know, he was doing well in the fight, and it was a brutal fight, but massive respect to Dave Ryan and John Wayne Hibbert.
Yeah, well done to both of you.
Yes, Rocky.